Hi students, welcome back to online classes. Today we are going to start that a new topic, that is the probability, chapter number 13, probability. So what is the weightage of this topic is? So the weightage of this topic is a 1 mark. 1 mark is a 1 plus 2 marks is a 1 plus 3 marks is a 1 plus 5 marks is a 1. Total is 11 marks weightage. 1 mark 1 and 2 marks 1 and 3 marks 1 and 5 marks 1. Total is 11 marks is the weightage. So in this topic we are going to discuss that. The first one is introduction. First one is the introduction, and the second one is conditional probability. Conditional probability, and the third one is multiplication theorem on probability, and the fourth one is independent events, and the fifth one is the Bayes theorem. So in this topic we are going to discuss these. The first one is the introduction, next one is the conditional probability, next one is the multiplication theorem on probability, and the next one is the independent events, and the next one is the Bayes theorem. So some concept is deleted from this topic. So that is the random variables, and the binomial distribution is deleted. So up to this one, Bayes theorem is there. So up to these five concepts we are going to discuss in this topic. Okay, so see that one, students. See students, in the previous year, that is the first PU, you are already started that probability, and we are already learned these concepts. We are here, once again we are repeating that concept. See that one first. What is the random experiment? Random experiment. For example, I am taking a toss here. I am taking a 2 coins. I am tossing the coin. What is the results is? If you are tossing the coin, what is the possibilities are? So that is nothing but, if you are tossing the coin, you will get the 2 heads and 1 head and 1 tail, and tail and head, and both are tails. If you are toss the coin, what is the outcomes are? 2 heads, head, tail, tail, head, and 2 tails. So here, so that this is that, what is that? This is called the random experiment. Why? Because what is the meaning of the random experiment is? An experiment is said to be a random experiment. It satisfies the following conditions. What is that one is? In the experiment, the number of outcomes is more than 1. The number of outcomes is more than 1. So here it is a more than 1. So it is a random experiment. And also see the second condition also. What is that one is? We cannot predict the result. So we cannot predict that what is the result you will get that one. You know what is the outcomes are. But you cannot predict what is the, if you are toss the coin, we cannot predict that what is the outcome is. So already know that what is the outcomes. But we cannot predict the result when you are conducted the experiment. So that type of experiments is called random experiment. What is the meaning of the random experiment? The outcomes is more than 1, and already noted what is the possible, what is the all possible outcomes, you know that. But in the experiment, what is the result, we cannot predict. So that is called the random experiment. Are you understand that? So see the second one is, what is the second one? Outcomes and the sample space. What is the outcomes? Outcome is nothing but the possible results in the experiment. The possible results in the experiment is called, the possible results in the experiment is called the outcomes. What is that? The possible results in the experiment is called the outcomes. And what is the sample space? The set of all possible outcomes. The set of all possible outcomes in the random experiment is called the sample space. And it is denoted by S. The set of all possible outcomes in the random experiment is called the sample space, and it is denoted by Yes. Are you understand that? So see the next one. What is that event? What is the event is? Event is nothing but any subset of the sample space, any subset of the sample space is called an event of the sample space, yes, with respect to the random experiment. So what is that any subset? For example, I will take that one. I am conducting an experiment here. S is equal to, I am sourcing the two coin. What is the event? E is an event. E is an event of getting, E is an event of getting at least that is a one head, that is a one head, at least that is a one head. So E is an event of getting a one head. So what is that? E is equal to, what is the E will become? E is equal to, what is the E? E is nothing but they are asking only one head. So what is that one? That is nothing but HT and TH. So here E is the subset of S. E is the event. Are you understand that? So E is an event of getting one head. So that is nothing but E is the an event, that is a subset E of the sample space S is called an event. Are you understand, students? So see the next one is types of events. What is the types of events is? So see the first one is impossible and sure events. Impossible and sure events. What is the impossible? Impossible is nothing but the event is not happening. So that is nothing but here, see this one. If I am tossing the coin two times, what is that? E is the event. E is the event that getting three heads. E is the event getting three heads. It is a possible here. It is not a possible. So that is called that E will become that. In that case, E will become that empty. Why? Because that case is not a possible here. It is an empty set. Are you understanding that? Why? Because I am tossing the two coins only. You can't get a three heads. So that meaning is that event is empty. So that event is called impossible event. That event is called impossible event. And what is the sure event? The sure event is nothing but the sample space, yes. The total set. The total set is called the sure event. That is the you have to take the sample space. Yes, is the sure event. And phi is a empty set. That is nothing but the impossible event. So that event is not happened. So that type of event is called impossible event. And the total sample space you will get that one. That type of event is called sure event. Sure event. Are you understand, students? So see the next one. What is that? Simple event. What is the simple event? Simple event is nothing but it has only one event. So in that event you will get only one event is happened. So that is nothing but you can see that one. The E is the event. E is the event. Event of getting. E is the event of getting two heads. E is the event of getting two heads when two coins are tossed. Are you understanding that? Same. Experiment is the same. I am tossing the two coin. E be the event of getting two heads. What is that? Then E is equal to what happens, students? E will become that. So how many outcomes are here? Only one outcome is there. Are you understanding that? So this event has only one outcome. So that event is called simple event or a simple point. Simple event or a simple point. Are you understanding that? It has only one outcome in that event. So that event is called simple event. Simple event. And see that next one is the compound event. Compound event. What is that compound event? So that is nothing but the probability that is already you are taken that here. It has a more than one simple event. More than one simple point is there. So then we can say that it is a compound event. For example, here E is an event of getting one head. It has a more than one point is there. One positive outcome is there. One outcome is there. So this is the HT and TH. Two outcomes are there. So this is nothing but compound events. More than one outcomes are there, so that event is called a compound event. Only one outcome is there, so that event is called a simple event. Okay, so see, the next one is event A or B. Event A or B, what is the meaning is that event A or B. So event A or B is nothing but it is denoted by A union B. Event A or B, what is the meaning is that students, A union B in the set, already we are calculated that in this model. So A union B, what is the meaning of A union B? So A union B is nothing but, so that is a omega, such that omega is a belongs to A or omega is belongs to B. So that event that outcome is belongs to the event A, or that event is belongs to the event B, then we can take that event, that a point is in A union B. So event A or B is nothing but it contains that is outcomes. What is that outcome? That outcome is the event of, that is the outcome is an event of A, or the outcome is the event of B. So see, the next one is event A and B. What is that meaning is, that is nothing but A intersection B. Event A and B. What is that one? That is the A intersection B. A intersection B is nothing but, what is that one is? So that is the omega, that is, we can take that omega is belongs to A and omega is belongs to B. So A intersection B has an outcome, it is a compulsory, that is an event of A, and also it is outcome of B also. So here A union B is, the outcome is, it is either the outcome of A or outcome of B. But here the event, that is A intersection B, has an outcome, that outcome compulsory, it is a both outcome. So that is the A and B, both events have that point. So that is the simple point. So then you can take that event, that is a point in the A union, A intersection B. So see, the next one is the event A but not B. The event A but not B. What is this meaning is, that is nothing but A minus B. That is also we can written as A intersection B complement. So we can take that A minus B is nothing but A intersection B complement. Are you understand, students? So see these concepts. See, the next one is mutually exclusive events. What is the meaning is that two events A and B are said to be mutually exclusive events is nothing but if the occurrence of one event excludes the occurrence of the second event. The occurrence of the second event. What is that meaning is, that is nothing but the two events does not occur simultaneously. That meaning is A and B are disjoint. That is nothing but A intersection B is equal to empty. What is the mutual exclusive events? That is nothing but the occurrence of the one event excludes the occurrence of the second event. That meaning is the two events does not occur simultaneously. That meaning is A and B are disjoint and A intersection B is empty. See, the next one, axiomatic approach to probability. So what is this one is, let S be the sample space and the outcomes are omega 1 and omega 2 and omega 3 and so on omega n. So if you can take this is the outcomes, then the sample space will become the S only. Then the definition, it follows that the definition of the axiomatic of to the probability, it follows some conditions. So what is that conditions are? See this one. The first one is 0 less than or equal to probability of omega I. So this is less than or equal to 1 for each omega I belongs to S. That meaning is, if we can take any outcome in the sample space, the probability of that outcome compulsory lies in between 0 to 1 only. The probability of any outcome compulsory lies in between 0 to 1 only. So see, the second one is, and the sum of all the outcomes, the sum of all the probabilities of the outcome, so that is nothing but P of omega 1 plus P of omega 2 plus and so on plus P of omega n. So the sum of all the probabilities will become the 1. The sum of all the probabilities of the outcomes will become the 1 only. And also, for any event A, P of A is equal to sigma probability of omega I. So here omega I belongs to A. So if you can take A is an event. What is the omega I? Omega I is the events of A. For all omega I. So that means if we can take that sum of all these probabilities of outcomes of A, then it will become that P of A only. Are you understand that? P of A is any event. If A is any event, then the summation of P of omega I. What is the omega I? Omega I is nothing but the outcomes in the event A. If you can take the sum of all the probabilities, it will become the probability of that event. Okay. So see this condition, students. So what is that? Axiomatic approaches to the probability. So S is the sample space. Then what is the conditions is possible here? So first one, if you can take any event in the sample space, that probability compulsory lies in between 0 to 1 only. The sum of all the events in the sample space, the sum will become the 1 only. That is the P of S is equal to 1. Are you understanding that? What is the meaning is that? P of S. So what is this meaning is? P of S is equal to 1. P of S is equal to 1. That is nothing but the probability of sure event. P of S is equal to 1. What is S? S is the sure event. P of S is nothing but the probability of sure event is a 1. What is the probability of impossible event? Empty set. Yes or no? So that meaning is, the probability of impossible event, it will become that. What is the sum of this probabilities? It will become the 0 only. So that is nothing but the probability of impossible event is a 0. The probability of sure event is 1. Okay, so this is the condition is here. Next one is, for any event A, P of A is equal to sigma P of omega I, where omega I is the outcome in the event A. Okay, so see this condition, students. See the next one. Probability of equally likely events. So what is the meaning of equally likely events is nothing but, in the experiment, each outcome has the same chances. That is nothing but, if you are toss a coin, that is the probability of getting the tail and the probability of getting the head. Both are same. That is nothing but equally likely events. And also, in the rolling the die, the outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each one have the same chance to get. So that is nothing but probability of getting the 1 is a 1 by 6. So probability of getting the 2 is a 1 by 6. So probability of 3 is a 1 by 6. And so on. And that means each one have the same chances. So that is nothing but it is called equally likely events. So here, what I am taking that, let S be the sample space. And E be an event. and E be an event such that n of s is equal to n and n of e is equal to m. N of e is equal to m, comma, and each event is equally likely events, then the probability of e is equal to the number of outcomes favorable to E by total possible outcomes. So that is nothing but N of E by N of S. So that is nothing but N of E by N of S is nothing but N of E value is M and N of S value is N. So that is nothing but S be the sample space and E be an event such that N of S is equal to N and N of E is equal to M and the outcomes are equally likely outcomes, then probability of E is equal to the number of outcomes favorable to E by the total possible outcomes. That is nothing but N of E by N of S. That is equal to M by N. And also we are used some condition, that is the addition theorem on probability. We are already used that. P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B if A intersection B is equal to empty, if A intersection B is empty, then implies P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. You are already learned this one in the first P, okay? And also we have probability of A complement, P of A complement or P of E complement, anyone, P of A complement is equal to 1 minus P of A, 1 minus P of A. So probability, the addition theorem on probability is nothing but P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. If A and B are a disjoint, that is A intersection B is a disjoint events, then P of A union B will become P of A plus P of B. And also P of A complement is nothing but 1 minus P of A. Okay. So see that, students. See the next one is the conditional probability. So what is the meaning of the conditional probabilities? Conditional probability is nothing but, so for example, what is the meaning of the conditional probabilities? So we can denote like this, P of E given by F. P of E given by F. So that meaning is nothing but we are calculating the probability of E. We are calculating the probability of E. What is F, sir? F is nothing but already this event is happened. So what is the meaning is that the event of happening E, before that already one event is happened. What is that? F event is happened. So that meaning is, I will give you one example. What is that one is? For example, I am tossing the three coins. What is the outcomes is? If you are tossing the three coins, what is the outcomes? That means three heads and two heads and one tail. Shuffle the terms, you will get that HTH, and shuffle the terms, you will get that THH. Next one is one head and two tails, that is nothing but HTT, shuffle the terms, THT, and shuffle the terms, TTH. Next, last one is all are tails. So that is nothing but if you are tossing the three coins, what is the sample space? The sample space has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is nothing but if you are tossing the coins, three coins, so the outcomes is 2 cube. So that is nothing but 8. So the outcomes is 8. So here I am taking the sample space. I am taking the two events. First one is E. What is E? E is that E be the event of getting at least two heads. let E be the event of getting at least two heads, and F be the event, F be the event of getting first coin shows a tail. So here I am taking that two events. What is that events are? The first one is E be the event of getting at least two heads. And what is the F? F be the event. F be the event of getting first coin shows a tail. So what is this? Here I will take that E. What is the E is? E is nothing but getting at least two heads. What is that possibilities are? So getting at least two heads. That is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At least two, that is nothing but you will get the four only, okay? So that is nothing but a head and HHT and HTH and THH. At least two heads. At least two heads is cases here. What is the F? F is nothing but the first coin shows tail. The first coin shows the tail. So what is that? 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is that? It will become that THH. The first coin shows tail. So that is nothing but THH, comma THT, THT and TTH and TTT. So this is the F. So this is the F. I am taking that E intersection F is equal to E intersection F. What is the E intersection F? So what is that intersection is? Intersection contains only one outcome. So what is that? THH only. So that is nothing but it has a THH. Only one outcome is there. So then what is the probability? What is the probability of E intersection F? What is the probability of E intersection F is equal to N of E intersection F by N of S. What is the probability of getting two heads and first coin shows tail? So what is the probability? That is nothing but N of E intersection F by N of S. N of S. So that is nothing but N of E intersection F is a 1. Why? Because only one event is there. That is a 1 by N of S. The number of outcomes in the sample space is 8. That is 8. So this is the, generally we will calculate the probability like this. But here, what is the conditional probability? Conditional probability is nothing but here, in this experiment, F is already occurred. What is F is occurred? Three coins are tossed. F is occurred. So then, the outcomes is you have to take only the sample space. You have to take F is the sample space. F is the sample space. So see this one here. So what is the condition is? Conditional probability. What is the meaning of the conditional probability is? So we are tossing a coin. F is the event of getting first coin shows tail. Is occurred, then what is the probability of getting at least two heads? Are you understand the difference? In the previous question, what is the probability of getting two heads and first coin shows a tail? But here what they are asking, that when the three coins are tossed, already the first coin shows a head. Then, what is the probability of getting at least two heads? In this case, what happens? The F is the sample space. The F will become the sample space. In this case, how to calculate that? So first we have to take that F. What is F? The first coin shows a tail. So what is that one? T H H. Next. T H T. Next. T T H. Next. T T T. So this is the F. Next, you have to take the E. What is E? E is nothing but getting at least one, that is getting at least two heads. Getting at least two heads. That meaning is you have to pick that event from F only. So in the previous one, what we are taking that these events we are taken from the S. From the sample space. But here what we will take that already F is already happened, so that's why the events of E we are taking from F only. So that is nothing but already this event is happened, so that's why next event you have to take E from this F only. So that meaning is what is E? They are asking at least two heads. Where is that case? Only one case is there, that is nothing but a THH. Are you understanding that? The difference you have to understand that. So this is the called the conditional probability. Already one event is happened. Then we are calculating the probability of E. So in that case, you have to take that this F is the sample space. So then we have to take the E. So you have to take the E from this F only. So then what is the P of E given by F? What is the P of E given by F? It is nothing but the probability of E given by F. Meaning is nothing but the event E is happened. Already one event is occurred. That is F is already happened. So in the before this event, already one event is happened. That probability you are calculating. What is that? P of E given by F is equal to the number of favorable outcomes in E intersection F by the number of outcomes in F. So that is nothing but N of E intersection F by N of F. So this can be taken it as N of E intersection F by N of S by N of F by N of S. So this can be written as N of E intersection by N of S is nothing but P of E intersection F by N of F by N of S is nothing but P of F. So P of E given by F, P of E given by F is nothing but the number of favorable outcomes in E intersection F by the number of outcomes in F. That is nothing but N of E intersection F by N of F. So that is equal to, so just divide with N of S, then it will can be written as N of E intersection one by N of E intersection F by N of S by N of F by N of S. What is this value? This is nothing but P of E intersection F. What is this value? Is nothing but P of F. So that is the definition here. So what is that? So the conditional probability E and F are two events. E and F are two events. So F event is occurs given that the probability of the event E. The probability of the event E is nothing but P of E given by F is equal to the number of favorable outcomes in E intersection F by the number of outcomes in F. So that is nothing but P of E intersection F by P of F. So this is called the conditional probability. So see the definition here. So what is that event? That is the conditional probability is E and F are two events associated with the same sample space. E and F are two events associated with the same sample space of a random experiment. of a random experiment. The conditional probability of the event E, given that F has occurred, that is P of E given by F. So what is that meaning is, the conditional probability of the event E, given that F has occurred. That meaning is, you are calculating the probability of E, already one event is already occurred, that is F event is already occurred. That probability, it is denoted by P of E given by F is given by, so what is that? That is nothing but P of E given by F is equal to the number of elementary the number of elementary events favorable to E intersection F by the number of elementary events favorable to the event F. So that is nothing but N of E intersection F by N of F. So we can divide it to N of S, N of E intersection F by N of S by N of F by N of S. So this can be written as P of E intersection F by P of F, comma P of F not equal to 0. P of F not equal to 0. So I understand that this is the definition of the conditional probability. So E comma F are two events in the same sample space, yes, with respect to the random experiment. Then the conditional probability of the event E is given that F occurred, that event F has occurred. It is given that P of E given by F, though we can be written as the number of elementary events favorable to the E intersection F by the number of elementary events favorable to the F. So that is nothing but N of E intersection F by N of F. So it can be written as P of E intersection F by P of F, and P of F is not equal to 0. P of F not equal to 0. Okay, students. So see that definition. See the next. Some properties in the conditional probability. So some conditions in the probability. Let E comma F are the events in the sample space S of a random experiment. Then we have some conditions here. The first property is, P of S given by F is equal to P of F given by F, that is equal to 1. P of S given by F and P of F given by F, both are equal to 1. So see this one here, students. So what is the proof you will get that? So probability of S given by F. So what is the meaning is that, I am already given the definition. What is the probability of E given by F? Is nothing but probability of E intersection F by probability of F. So here probability of S intersection F we can written as P of S intersection F by P of F. Already we know that since F is the subset of S. F is the subset of S. So that implies F intersection S, it will become the F only. F is the subset of S. Why? Because F is an event in the sample space. Okay. So automatically F intersection S, it will become the F only. So that implies what happens? P of S intersection F, it will become that P of F by P of F. So both the will be cancelled. It will become the one only. It will become one. And also similarly, what we will take that P of F given by F. P of F given by F. What is the definition? The definition of the conditional probability is P of F given by F. It is in the form of P of E given by F. Yes or no? So by the definition, what we can written as P of F intersection F by P of F. So F intersection F, what is that F intersection F? That implies it will become the one only. It will become the one only. Why? Because both the sets are same, the intersection will get the same. So that meaning is P of F intersection F, it will become the P of F only. So it will become that P of F. So by P of F, so that implies both will be cancelled, it will become the one. So therefore, what we can write as P of S given by F is equal to P of F given by F, both are equal to 1. Both are equal to 1. Okay. So see this condition, students. See the property number 2. So what is the property number 2 is? If A and B are any two events, if A and B are any two events of a sample space, yes. And F is an event and F is an event of S such that P of F not equal to 0, P of F not equal to 0, P of F not equal to 0, then P of A union B given by F, P of A union B given by F is equal to P of A given by F plus P of B given by F minus P of A intersection B given by F. In particular, A and B are disjoint events. P of A union B given by F is equal to P of A given by F plus P of B given by F. Okay. So this is the condition we have to prove that. So see that one proof. Very easy one. So see that one first. What they are asking to you. This is the condition they are asking. What is that? P of A union B given by F. P of A union B given by F. It is in the form of P of E given by F. What is the P of E given by F formula is? P of E intersection F by P of F. Yes or no? So here, what is this? This is E and this is F. So what it happens? P of E intersection F. E value is A union B. So that is nothing but A union B intersection F whole by P of F. P of F is nothing but you will get the F only. In the place of E, you have A union B. That is P of E intersection F by P of F. In the place of E, you have A union B. So next, you can see this one, students. A union B intersection F. Already you know the distributive law. What is the distributive law is? So already you know the condition. That is nothing but A union B intersection C is equal to, apply the distributive law, what happens? A intersection C union B intersection C. B intersection C. So the distributive law we are going to apply here. So that is nothing but A union B intersection F, we can written as a P of A intersection F union B intersection F by P of F, by P of F. So here already we know that condition. What is that? A union B. What is the A union B formula? I am already given that. A union B, you can written as A union P of A union B. P of A union B can be written as P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Already know this form. So it is also in the form of P of A union B. P of A union B you can written as a P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So that is nothing but what we can written as P of A. This is A. So that is P of A intersection F plus P of B. B is nothing but P of B intersection F minus P of A intersection B. This is A and this is the B. So what happens? A intersection F intersection B intersection F whole by P of F. Whole by P of F. I will separate the terms, students. So what is that one? Is the first one I will take that P of A intersection F by P of F. Next. Plus P of B intersection F by P of F. And this is a minus A intersection F intersection B intersection F. It can be written as P of A intersection B intersection F by P of F. Yes or no? F intersection F is a F only. All the intersection is the, all the functions is the intersection only. We can written as A intersection B intersection F. I am taking A intersection B as a set. Okay. So A intersection B intersection F. Nothing will be happens. So why I am written that? It is the definition. Already what is the definition is P of E given by F. What is the P of E given by F? Is nothing but P of E intersection F by P of F. P of E intersection F by P of F. Then it will become P of E given by F. So here it is in the place of E you have A. So then what happens? It will become P of A given by F. Here in the place of E you have a B. So it will become that P of B given by F. So here minus in the place of E you have A intersection B. It can be written as P of A intersection B given by F. P of A given by F. It is a P of B given by F minus P of A intersection B given by F. So what we can conclude that therefore P of A union B given by F we can written as P of A given by F plus P of B given by F minus P of A intersection B given by F. So in the next case they are already asking this one. This is the first condition. In the second one what they are asking that in particular A and B are disjoint events. If A and B are disjoint events, I will take a, this is the one. I will take this condition is the one. So A and B are disjoint events. So in particular what they are asking to you, in particular A and B are disjoint events. A and B are disjoint events. That implies A intersection B, it will become empty. So that implies P of A intersection B, it will become 0. If it will become 0, then P of A intersection B given by F, it will become 0. P of A intersection B given by F, it will become the 0 only. Why? Because P of A intersection B is 0. Automatically, P of A intersection B given by F will become the 0 only. Therefore, from 1, P of A union B given by F is equal to P of A given by F plus P of B given by F. So P of A intersection B given by F, it will become 0. Then automatically P of A union B given by F will become that P of A given by F plus P of B given by F only. Okay. So see that case, students. In particular, A and B are disjoint events. In that case, A intersection B is empty. So then P of A in intersection B will become 0. Then P of A intersection B given by F, it will become the 0 only. So from 1, substitute this value in equation 1, you will get that P of A union B given by F, it will become that P of A given by F plus P of B given by F only. Okay. So see this property, students. See the next property, property number 3. So what is the property number 3 is? So see that one. Probability of E complement given by F. Probability of E complement given by F is nothing but 1 minus probability of E given by F. Probability of E complement given by F. E complement given by F is equal to 1 minus probability of E given by F. So see here, already we know that from property number 1, we know that probability of S given by F is equal to 1 from property number 1. From property number 1, we are already proved this one. P of S given by F is equal to 1. So, and also that implies P of this S, I will return that E union E complement given by F, that is equal to 1. Why? Because A in union A complement, it will become the total sample space. Yes or no? So E union E complement. E union E complement. Since E union E complement, it will become the total sample space. Yes or no? Yes or no? So here you can observe this one. So this is the sample space, and if it is a E, if it is a E, so what is the E complement? E complement is the remaining part. This is the E complement. So this is the E complement. E union E complement, it will become the sample space. E union E complement, it will become the sample space only. So that's why what I am taking, that E union E complement will become the sample space. So that implies what happens, it can be written as, and also, yes, I am written E union E complement. Next one, from property number 2. What is the property number 2 is? That is nothing but P of E given by F plus P of E complement given by F. That is equal to 1. Why? Because some property number from property number 2. What is that? Property 2. A and B are disjoint. So that implies probability of A union B given by F is equal to, what is that? P of A given by F plus P of B given by F. Why? Because already we are proved that in the property number 2 in a particular case, what is that? If A and B are disjoint events, then we can written as P of A union B given by F, we can written as P of A given by F plus P of B given by F only. So here already you know that E and E complement are disjoint events. Yes or no? E intersection E complement is empty only. That means it is joined. So in that case, we can use this property here. A and B are disjoint events. Then you can E and E complement are disjoint events. So it is the same form. You can written as a P of E given by F plus P of E complement given by F will become the 1 only. So what I will take that one? That implies, take this value to that side. What happens? P of E complement given by F, it will become that 1 minus P of E given by F only. So therefore, P of E complement given by F can be written as 1 minus P of E given by F. So we are used that property number 1 and property number 2. So see that case once again, students. P of E complement given by F is equal to 1 minus P of E given by F. So first we are already in the property number 1, we are already proved that probability of S given by F, probability of S given by F is equal to 1. Already we are proved this. So what is the definition? This is a S can also we can written as E union E complement. Why? Because E and U complement are disjoint events and mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Intersection is empty and union is the sample space. So that is nothing but mutually exclusive and exhaustive. Exhaustive is nothing but the union will become the sample space. Mutually exclusive meaning is intersection is empty. So E union E complement is the sample space. E intersection E complement is empty. So S can be written as E union E complement. So given by F. So and E complement are disjoint events. So by the property number 2, you have probability of A union B given by F, you can written as a probability of A given by F plus a probability of B given by F. So we can take it as a P of E given by F plus probability of E complement given by F, that is equal to 1. Take this down to that side, you will get the probability of E complement given by F is equal to 1 minus P of E given by F only. Okay, so see this property, students, and we will continue in the next class. Okay.